Okay, so we are going to begin and so like I say, we want to learn how to go through flow sequences and start at the beginning and keep going. And so now I want you to stay down the floor. We're going to start off with working ourselves gradually into the sun salutation. And so the sun salutation is going to be our first posture, our first sequence. Then we're going to follow with Teken sequence. Then we're going to follow that with Ma'at Ka. And so what I want you to do is to come up onto your hands and knees. And you're going to put your thighs together, put your feet together. And you're going to put your, let your thighs touch together, let your feet touch together. And then I want you to fold your toes underneath your feet. Put your hands next to your legs and ease your weight down onto your toes. And you want your toes to bend at a 90 degree angle. Let your hands rest upon your thighs. Relax your shoulders. You want your toes to release. You want your toes to bend at a 90 degree angle. You want the bottom of your toe to come flat to the floor while the balls of your feet touch the floor. Breathe in slowly. And breathe out slowly. Keeping the tip of your tongue connected to the roof of your mouth. And you're breathing in. And you're slowly breathing out. As you breathe in, visualize life force and energy rising from below your navel, going up your spine, coming to the crown of your head, and then migrating into the middle of your forehead. On your exhalation, visualize life force and energy flowing through your arms, going down into your hands, going down your legs and into your feet. And then as you breathe in, let your arms rise. Let the inhalation of the breath lift your arms. Let the exhalation of your breath bring your body forward, bring your hands to the floor. Lift your feet and wiggle your toes. Point your feet. Place your insteps or the top of your feet to the floor. Make sure you keep your knees together, keep your thighs together, keep your feet together. And you're going to reach your left hand back, turning it backwards. Reach your right hand back. And you're going to use your hands to control your weight. And you're going to gradually ease your weight down onto your heels, letting the insteps come flat, lengthening the shin muscle. This from your knee down to your ankle, that muscle there. And then you got your back straight, your hands resting upon your thighs. This is called Sesh Pose, Variation 3. Use your inhalation to bring your hands into Merkut. Merkut, M-E-R-K-H-U-T, means pyramid. Let your hands come down to the floor. Your back is straight. You lift your chest. You breathe in. Slowly exhale. Easing your chest to your thighs, your forearms to the floor, and your forehead into the Merkut or the pyramid that your hands are making. And you're breathing in slowly. As you exhale, relax your neck, relax your shoulders, releasing comfortably into the position. Let your knees relax. Let your ankles relax. Let your hips and your spine relax. Breathe in. Breathe out. Push against the floor and rise up. Breathe in as you come up. Let your arms come up. Let your hands come up. Arms are shoulders height. And as you exhale, come up onto your hands and knees into what we call tabletop. From this position, transition into lunge on the left leg. And so that means that the left leg is going to receive the action. So the right leg goes forward. The right foot goes forward. We place the hands on each side of the right foot. And we bend the toes of the left foot and we lift the left knee up. We lower the hips, we bring the chest up, we look forward. We keep the neck relaxed, we keep the shoulders relaxed. And we breathe in and out slowly. Breathe in. As you exhale, gently place your left knee down to the floor. Lift your left knee and your left foot and point it, place your instep to the mat. Place your arms underneath your right thigh and then you're breathing in slowly as you lift your body and raise your arms. You hold the position here with your hands about 3/4 of the way up. And then you exhale and bring your palms together as if you're trying to squeeze your head in between your arms. As you breathe in, put your left hand behind your right hand. As you exhale, release your shoulders and place your hands to your right knee. Focus on your left thigh. Breathe in. And then slowly use your exhalation to lengthen your left thigh. Open up your left hip. You want to take your time. You want to ease into the position as you slowly exhale. The exhalation of the breath releases resistance from your body and allows your body to ease itself into the posture. Now we're going to layer the next movement on top of this. So we maintain the body in this position. We breathe in and we lift the chest. When we exhale, we push against the knee and we arch the spine back. We let the head come up. We let the chest come down. We separate the hands and we ease the hands down to the mat. And now we want to duplicate the same posture on the opposite side of the body. So we take the left foot and we bring the left foot forward. We bend the toes of the right foot and we lift the right knee up. We lower the hips, we bring the chest up and we look forward. We breathe in. We exhale the right knee down. We point the right foot. We place the instep to the mat. We place the arms underneath the left thigh. And we use the inhalation to rise. We use the exhalation to squeeze the head in between the arms, putting the palms together, lengthening to the latissimus dorsi. Opening up the trapezius muscles at the shoulders. Use the inhalation to put the left hand behind the right. Use the exhalation to lower the hands down to the left knee. And then from here, we're gonna work on the hip and the thigh, the pelvis. Breathe in. And as we exhale, we lengthen the right thigh. We keep the back straight. We want to put all the emphasis on going straight down towards the earth. opening up that middle section of the body. Then with the inhalation, we lift the chest. With the exhalation, we arch the spine back. We bring the head up. We exhale the chest down. We separate the hands and we ease the hands down. Okay. And then we bring the left leg back. Okay. One second. Okay. Now we completed the lunge on the left leg, then the right leg. We bring the thighs together and then we breathe in. And with the exhalation, we ease the weight backward. We bend the knees. We try to get the buttocks to the heels. We try to get the buttocks to the heels, the chest to the thighs. And the forehead towards the floor. And we want to relax, easing the body downward into the position. And then breathe in. Slowly breathe out. Breathe in. Slowly breathe out, massaging the internal organs as you breathe in and exhale. This position is called Mesu Heru. Now, let your head come up. I want you to look forward. You're going to keep your hands flat on the floor. You're going to spread your fingers. And what we're going to do is essentially transfer the weight from the knees into the hands. So with your inhalation, I want you to lift your elbows, but keep your face close to the floor, about 2 inches from the floor. When you exhale, I want you to transfer your weight into your hands. Once you get your hips to the floor, you breathe in and you push against the floor of your arms, lift your chest and arch your spine. Breathe in slowly through your nose. Breathe out slowly through your nose. Fold your toes underneath your feet. Lift your knees as you breathe in, push your hips up. Now, take your left foot. Move it about 2 or 3 inches forward. Take your right foot, move it about 2 or 3 inches forward. Breathe in. When you exhale, push against the heels of your hands. Push backwards, straighten your arms, straighten your back, straighten your legs, try to get your heels to touch the floor. Keep your neck relaxed. Keep your facial muscles relaxed. As you breathe in, rise up to the balls of your feet. As you slowly exhale, touch your knees down to the mat. Now bring your head up. You're coming at the tabletop. Lift your feet and point your toes. Place your feet flat, or place the top of your feet flat to the floor. Straighten them. Take your right hand and move it about 3 inches in front of your right knee. Take your left hand and move it about 3 inches in front of your left knee. Now, breathe in, and as you exhale, you sit down onto your heels. You want your arms to straighten, you want your chest to remain lifted. You want your eyes to gaze forward. Hold this position, which we call the cheetah position. C-H-E-E-T-A-H. Now take your left forearm, place your left forearm onto the mat in front of your left knee. Place your right forearm until both your arms are parallel with each other. This is called Heru M-Akit. The other people call it a sphinx. The proper name is Heru M-Akit. We breathe in. We slowly breathe out. We breathe in and we expand the abdomen. We breathe out and we contract the abdomen. Take your left hand and reach, spread your fingers and reach out as far as you can. Reach out with your right hand as far as you can. Breathe in. We're going to transition from Heru M'Akit into Wajet, the cobra. Elbows up, face close to the floor. You exhale forward. You inhale up, and you exhale as you arch. And you breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. Fold your toes, lift your knees, inhale your hips up. Take your left foot, walk it forward. Take your right foot, walk it forward. Push against the heels of your hands and push backwards as you exhale and get your heels to the floor. Relax your neck, relax your shoulders. As you breathe in, rise up to the balls of your feet. As you exhale, slowly touch your knees down to the floor. Let your head come up and look forward. Lift your feet and point your toes and place your insteps down. Breathe in, and as you are exhaling, bend your knees. Put your buttocks down to your heels. Fold at the waist and bring your chest to your thighs. Let your forearms, let your forehead come down to the mat. Your arms are extended forward. You breathe in. You slowly breathe out. When you breathe in, expand your abdomen. When you exhale, contract your abdomen. Relaxing into the posture. Then rise up onto your hands and knees. Put your thighs together, put your feet together, and fold your toes underneath your feet. Put your left hand back next to your left leg. Put your right hand back next to your right leg. Sit down onto your heels. Open up your toes. Increase the arch in the bottom of your feet. Lengthening your Achilles tendon. Stimulating the reflexology points in the bottom of your feet that correspond to the throat to the top of the head. From your feet. Let your hands rest upon your thighs. Again, this is the Kemetic posture called Sesh Pose Variation 2. We hold this position, we breathe in, we slowly breathe out. We place the hands to the floor next to the knees. And we're going to lift the knees, push back onto the bottom of the feet, bend your body forward. And then as we breathe in, we rise up. As we exhale, we place the weight into the bottom of the feet and we sink downward into the earth, becoming rooted. Empty the shoulders, the elbows, the wrists, and the fingers. Okay, then from here, we're going to come with the legs together, the two big toes touch together, the heels separate. We're going to transition directly into our Teken sequence. Teken is T-E-K-E-N. We take the hands and we create Kemetic palms. We press the arms down. We lift the chest, we lower the shoulders. We rotate the arms from the shoulders We extend out and lift up on the inhalation. On the exhalation, we bring hands together. As we inhale, we tilt the head back halfway. As we exhale, we release the neck and we allow the head to go back. Breathe in and bring the head up straight. Let the back of your hands come together. Exhale, easing the arms down. Breathe in. On your exhalation, you're going to shift your hips back so your legs remain straight. Engage your hamstrings, bending forward. Let your knees bend enough so you can touch your knuckles or the back of your fingers to the floor comfortably. Keep the weight balanced in the bottom of your feet so that your hands are free. Your chin is to your chest. Now, as you breathe in, reach your hands back and grab your lower legs. As you exhale, lower your chest to your thighs. Try to get your chin to your knees. Inhale your hands into pyramid shape or Merkut. Exhale and try to get your palms to come flat to the floor. Relax your neck, relax your shoulders, opening up your upper back. Now straighten your legs. Let your body rise up slowly. When you come up from your waist. So you're not hunching your shoulders. You're not using your back muscles to come up. The inhalation of your breath lifts you up. The exhalation of your breath eases your weight into the bottom of your feet as you bend your knees. Now, straighten your legs. We're going to transition into the pose of Asar. Asar representing resurrection. The right palm comes in front of the chest. The left hand comes on the back of the right. The thumbs touch together into Merkut. We're going to isolate at the lower back, middle back, and then upper back as we turn to the left. So we breathe in through the nose, tip of the tongue connected to the roof of the mouth. We gradually breathe out as we turn to the left. Turn from your lower back, your middle back, and then your upper back. Let your body turn completely all the way to the left, isolating the upper body from the lower body. Now breathe in. As you exhale, turn your head to the right. Release your neck, release your shoulders. As you breathe in, turn your head to the center. As you exhale, turn your head to your left. Turn your head to the center, bring your chin over your chest. Use the inhalation of your breath to turn your body to the front and then exhale. Now breathe in. You want you to slowly turn to your right. Breathe out as you turn to your right. Release resistance from your spine along with the release of the exhalation of your breath. Once you get your entire spine from your lower back, middle back, and upper back twisted, then we're going to work on the cervical vertebrae of the neck. So we breathe in, and as we exhale, we turn the head to the left. Release the neck, release the shoulders. As we breathe in, we turn the head to the center. As we exhale, we turn the head to the right, turning the head in all both directions, opening up the neck, and then turn the head back to the center, Use the inhalation of the breath to turn the body to the front and then exhale. From here, we breathe in. And as we exhale, we open up the arms. The palms face forward. And breathe in. Slowly breathe out. Transitioning into pose of Selkett. We want to feel that energy forming around the palms of the hand. Now we take the right hand and we place it in front of the chest. The right elbow points straight out to the side, but the shoulder is relaxed. The left hand comes to the back of the right, the thumbs touch in a pyramid shape. We're going to transition into pose of men. So we breathe in. We slowly turn to the left as we exhale. Lower back, middle back, and then upper back is twisting. Once we get the body turned to the left, we breathe in. And as we exhale, we get the left arm go straight back, opening up the pectoral muscles of the chest. We put the right palm to the chest. We breathe in. When we exhale, we bend that left arm, making a right angle. We breathe in again. And as we exhale, slowly we turn the head to the front, opening up each vertebra of the neck, one at a time. Stimulating the glands and organs in the throat, stimulating the vagus nerve, stimulating all the major arteries that run through the throat and the neck into the head. When you breathe in, you turn your head to the center. When you exhale, you turn your head and you look towards your left arm. Turn your head in the opposite direction. Now turn your head and line up your chin with your chest. As you breathe in, you turn your body to the front. Hold it here, and then exhale your left hand to the back of your right hand. Your thumbs touch together, palms are flat, shoulders relaxed. And then breathe in through your nose. As you exhale, you turn to your right. Remember to turn from your lower back. Take your time. Ease the breath out as you go into your twisting position. Now breathe in. As you exhale, let your right arm go straight back. Put your left palm to your chest, twisting your spine. Breathe in. Exhale and bend your right arm. Make it a right angle. Breathe in. As you exhale, turn your head to your left. As you inhale, turn your chin over your chest. Exhale and turn your head to the right. Turn your head, bring your chin over your chest. Breathe in as you turn to the front. Move your left hand, put your right hand in front of your left hand, in front of your chest. Put your left hand on the back of your right, thumbs touching, making a Merkut. Breathe in and elevate the arms up above the head. Slowly exhale, open up your arms. Feel the energy surrounding your body like an aura of energy moving from left hand to right, from right hand to left. Breathe in. Slowly breathe out. Breathe in. And then exhale, the arms down. Release your shoulders. Let your arms go from side to side. You put a slight twist in your spine and your arms move like spaghetti arms. Releasing tension from the shoulders, the elbows, the wrists, and the fingers. Now let's step back. to the back part of the mat. We're going to transition into our next flow sequence, which is called Ma'at Ka. The word Ma'at means the idea of universal order, balance, harmony, justice, and reciprocity. The word Ka means spirit. So we bring the feet together. We let the two big toes touch. The heels have a slight distance between them. The hands are bent, are folded into a light fist. So you're not making it feel like you're gonna punch somebody. It's a light fist. The fingertips come into the middle of the palm. The thumb comes on top of the fingers. The arms are pressing downward. You want to engage your arm muscles. You wanna lower your shoulders, lift your chest, have a straight neck and shoulders. Straight neck and flat shoulders. Now shift your weight into your right foot and let your knees bend. Breathe in and lift your left knee as high as you can. Exhale and extend the left heel and then lower the heel down to the mat. Move your weight into your left foot. Free your right foot. Find your balance and extend the right foot back. Find balance between both your feet. Now, open up your palms into Kemetic palms. By the way, when we're in this position, this is, we also know this as Sahu. We talked about that before. Open up the hands. Rotate the arms out to the side. Extend the arms and inhale up. Exhale and bring the hands together. Inhale and tilt the head halfway back. Exhale, release the neck, let your hair go back. Breathe in and bring the head up straight. Now hold it here. We're gonna bend forward in one motion with the exhalation. We're gonna touch the fingertips to the floor. We breathe in and we rise up. We exhale and release the neck, allow the head to go back. We breathe in, we bring the head up straight. We let the back of the hands come together and we exhale, make a straight line. Now breathe in. Slowly turn to your right as you exhale. Now, turn the palms into the same direction as your body is turning. Bend your arms at the elbows as you breathe out, making right angles. Now breathe in. Slowly turn your head to the left as you exhale. Inhale your chin over the chest. Exhale and turn your head to the right. Turn your head and bring your chin over your chest. Breathe in and turn your body to the front. Slowly exhale and bring your palms together in front of your chest. Now, come up onto your left heel. Bend your right knee. Shift your hips back and tuck your hips. Now, from here, you take your time and you breathe in, and you're going to shift your hips back more as you bend forward, lengthening the muscles in the back of your left leg, opening up your left hip. Let your hands come down and touch your big toe. Now, bend your arms halfway to your chest. When you breathe in, you come up from your waist. Don't use your shoulders. Don't use your back. Move from your core. Your back is straight, both legs straight, both feet are flat on the floor. Use the inhalation of your breath to extend your arms up. Use the exhalation of your breath to ease your head back. Breathe in and bring your head up straight. Let the back of your hands come together and slowly exhale and make a straight line from fingertip to fingertip. Now breathe in. When you exhale, I want you to shift your hips back. Bring your body parallel with the floor. Keep both your legs straight. Breathe in. As you exhale, you're gonna rotate downward with your left hand coming down, your right arm going up. You stiffen your left hand, lock the back of your left hand to the inner part of your left foot. Turn your head and look up at your right hand. Open up your neck, open up your spine. Now, turn your body parallel with the ground. Breathe in and rise up. As you exhale, bend your arms at the elbow. Breathe in. Slowly bring the palms together, compressing the big giant ball of energy between your palms, turning that ball of energy down to the size of a marble. And then use your inhalation to extend your arms up. Use your exhalation to release your neck and allow your head to go back. Bring your head up straight. Let the back of your hands come together. Exhale, make a straight line. Breathe in again. And as you exhale, ease your arms down, release from your shoulders. Place your hands into Kemetic fist, bending your left knee. Inhale, your right knee up. Exhale, your right foot down next to your left foot. And breathe in. Slowly breathe out. Okay, we're almost at the finish line. So now we must do the opposite side of the body. So the two big toes touch, the heels slightly separate, the knees bend and the pelvis tuck. We shift the weight into the left foot. We inhale the right knee up. We exhale and extend, lower the heel to the floor. Transfer the weight into the right foot. Free the left foot, adjust your stance, find your balance. Open up your palms, rotate your arms from the shoulders. Use the inhalation of your breath to lift your arms 3/4 of the way up. Use the exhalation of your breath to bring your hands together. Use your inhalation to tilt your head halfway back. Exhale, release your neck, allow your head to go back. Breathe in and bring your head up straight. Shifting your hips back, bending forward and touching your fingertips to the floor. Breathe in and rise up. Breathe out and let your head go back. Breathe in and bring your head up straight. Let the back of your hands come together and exhale. Breathe in. Exhale to your left. Turn your palms to your left. Breathe in. Exhale and bend your arms, making right angles. Inhale. Exhale and turn your head to the right. Inhale, turn your head to the center. Exhale as you turn your head to the left. Turn your head back to the center. Breathe in as you turn your body forward. Slowly exhale as you bring your palms together, compressing the energy between your hands. Come up on your right heel. Shift your hips back as you bend your left knee. Breathe in. You're going to use that inhalation to exhale down into the posture. Let your hands come down and touch your big toe. Bend your arms at the elbows. As you inhale, rise up. As you exhale, put both feet flat, both legs straight. As you breathe in, you extend the arms up. As you exhale, you release your neck, allow your head to go back. Breathe in and bring your head up straight. Let the back of your hands come together and exhale. Inhale, as you exhale, shift your hips back. Bring your body parallel with the floor. Breathe in, exhale, and rotate so that your right hand locks to the inside of your right foot. Your left arm is straight up. You turn your head and you look up at your left hand. Turn your body parallel with the floor. As you breathe in, rise up. As you exhale, bend your arms. Now breathe in. Slowly compress that energy. You have a big ball of energy between your hands. You're compressing it down to the size of a marble between your palms. Use your inhalation to extend. Use your exhalation to release your neck, allow your head to go back. Use your inhalation to bring your head up. Let the back of your hands come together. Exhale. Breathe in. Exhale your arms down. Put your fists next to your body, bending your right knee. And as you inhale, lift your left knee up. Point your left toe towards the floor. Lower your left foot down next to your right foot. And breathe in. Slowly breathe out. Breathe in. Slowly exhale. Now release. Open up your shoulders. Release your elbows, your wrists, and your fingers.